Hello, in this video, we shall explore the use of data flows in Oracle Analytics, emphasizing key features and best practices for effective use across different use cases. Oracle Analytics data flows provide an intuitive and visual interface for performing lightweight ETL processes, allowing users to create datasets by applying multiple transformation operations to data from diverse sources. These are the available data flow transformations that can be placed under four main classifications. Data ingestion, such as adding the source data, data preparation that involves data operations like filter, union, etc., machine learning steps, and database analytics operations. Let's begin by building a simple data flow. In Oracle Analytics homepage, create a data flow and add the source data set from which the data will be extracted. We can also add multiple source datasets using the add data step and merge the datasets as needed by applying either the join or union row steps. Next, we will use the filter step to narrow down the data and select the columns needed for the output dataset. Use the branch step to save the result as a dataset, and on the other branch, add an aggregation function to create a second output dataset. Add another save data to directly save the output dataset as a table in the database. Now, when the data flow is executed, it creates output datasets with distinct data, and one of these datasets is also written to a database schema table, making it available for various reporting purposes. It is recommended to perform data preparation operations on the input dataset or within the data flow rather than on the output datasets. Also, the toggle can be used to hide the preview section, improving the performance within the data flow editor while loading the objects. Furthermore, if dealing with large input datasets or complex transformations, it is advisable to split the data flow into multiple smaller data flows and use the sequence feature to schedule them collectively with a defined execution order. This helps in monitoring and enhancing the overall execution performance. The data flow can be executed on an ad hoc basis or scheduled to run to update the target datasets at specific time in case of changes in the source data. To schedule a data flow, navigate to the data flows. Click on the actions menu of the specific data flow and select new schedule. Specify the schedule name, start and end dates, and frequency of the data flow execution. Let's now examine the data flow and review the two key options available in the inspect section. Along with displaying the general information about the data flow, the Schedules tab shows the schedules created by the logged in user, which can be updated here. If the user has administrator permissions, all schedules of the data flow will be visible. Go to the Access tab where the data flow owner can share the data flow with other users or application roles. Once shared, these users will be able to see the data flow in the data flows page. Keep in mind that the users or roles with whom the data flow is shared must have access to the connections and datasets used by the shared data flows. A best practice is to assign access to application roles instead of individual users, as this would streamline access management and simplify security administration. Additionally, ensure the data flow is executed by the owner before sharing the data flow. Moving on to the History tab. This displays the history of the data flow executions, and clicking on a record will display additional details of the run. In the event of failures, navigate to the record and click on the failed status. This will display a log snippet of the execution, providing error details that can be used to take corrective actions. Here is a summary of best practices covered in this video for using data flows. This concludes our discussion on utilizing the data flows feature for efficient data management and analysis in Oracle Analytics. Thanks for watching this video.